Good evening, sir. This way, please.
My apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
And the statesman, because he's so great, thinks his trade as honest as mine. A lawyer is an honest employment, so
he's seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up. And
for tis but fitting that we should protect our carriage seats.
Since we live by him.
Sir, Blackmore, that sick word of trial, comes on in the afternoon, and she hopes you will order matters so as to bring her off.
As the wench is very active and industrious, you may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
A thousand pardons.
Okay, sir.
My apologies.
No lazy dog. When I took him the time before, I told him what he would come to if he did not mend his hand. This is debt without reprieve. I may venture to book him. Poor Tom Gag. £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from the transportation. Or I can get more by her staying in.
Betty hath brought more goods into our lofty year than any private again. And in truth, 'tis a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her off, she may, in the common course of business, live her 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always lets the end fly through his life because the breed of the game depends on it. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There's nothing to be got by the death of women, except our wives.
Without dispute, she is a fine woman, because to her I was obliged for my education. And to say a false word, she hath trained up more young fellows to the business than the gaming table.
Truly, Filch, my observation is right. We and the surgeons are more beholden to women than all the professions we see.
So, that wall, that's it.
Tis woman that city is, says all mankind. Like her we first were taught our evening art. Her very eyes can cheat when both she's gone. She gives us of our money in the heart.
Well, I love to make them easy one way or other.
When a gentleman is long kept in suspense, penitence may break his...
Hey, Ethel. You should have come to me. We would have found another way. Yes, but then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
As am I.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. If this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that would be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge. Perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command. Although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you'll want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor.